Now let us see what is the impact of any financial transaction on the assets and liabilities of the business. This is the final equation which we have arrived at, which says assets are equal to owned funds or net worth of the company, net worth plus outside liabilities. Now let us take some examples. What is the impact of a financial transaction on the assets and liabilities of the business? Suppose a business purchases goods for rupees 1 lakh. You have purchased goods for 1 lakh. What has happened to your balance sheet? Your cash has come down by 1 lakh rupees. But what has increased? Your goods have increased. Another asset has increased. One asset has come down, cash has come down, but the quantum of goods has increased. Good is also an asset of the company. So another asset goes up. What happens to the total assets of the company? Total assets remain the same. Individual items change, but the total remains the same. Now what happens if you purchase the goods for rupees 1 lakh on credit? What will happen here? What will happen to the assets? Total assets will go up or go down? Total assets will go up because goods have increased. Your inventory has increased. What has happened to the liability? You have to pay this 1 lakh to the outsiders. Your payables figure has increased. Your liability has increased. So your outside liability has also increased by 1 lakh. Assets have increased by 1 lakh. Your liability has increased by rupees 1 lakh. So both assets and liabilities have gone up. Now take another case. You purchase fixed assets. Suppose rupees 5 lakhs. You took a loan of rupees 4 lakhs for this and cash payment rupees 1 lakh. What happens to your assets? Your assets increase by rupees 5 lakhs because fixed assets have gone up by rupees 5 lakhs. That is the purchase price of this. And what happens to the cash? Cash has gone down by 1 lakh. So total increase is only 4 lakhs in the asset. What has happened to the liabilities? Liabilities have gone up by rupees 4 lakhs because loan of the bank has increased by rupees 4 lakhs. So both assets and liabilities have gone up. When you take the total, one side of the balance sheet, total assets have gone up by rupees 5 lakhs and total liabilities have also gone up by rupees 5 lakhs. Now let us take certain MCQs, multiple choice questions, which are asked in the examination. In the examination, the purpose is to test your basic conceptual understanding of the issues involved. So here the issue involved are: one side of the balance sheet which represents assets are equal, that side is equal to the total liabilities which is represented on the other side of the balance sheet. Total assets are equal to total liabilities. Second issue involved is that liabilities consist of two things: owned funds and outside liabilities. So 3-4 MCQs, multiple choice questions, I have prepared. Let us take the first of these. This says what happens when a loan is converted into equity. These are the assets. These are the liabilities. Question is, what happens when a loan is converted into capital? How such a situation can arise? How a loan is converted into capital? Partners may decide to do it. In case of a partnership firm, the partners may decide that rupees 10 lakh, which was the loan there, now that will be treated as a capital. Or in case of a company, this normally happens when the company becomes sick or sticky. In that case, the lenders, they decide that part of the loan will be converted into equity so that it becomes a viable enterprise and ultimately the money can be recovered. So what happens to the loan and what happens to the equity or capital? Equity, which is part of the net worth. The loan amount is reduced. This is reduced by 10 lakhs. Reduced. What happens to the equity? This increases by rupees 10 lakhs. So what is the impact of conversion of loan into equity? The capital is increased and the loan is reduced. What happens to the assets? Absolutely no impact on the assets. All assets remain the same. When all assets remain the same, total liability will also remain the same. Only there is interchange between the loan and the equity, between owned funds and the outside liability. So the correct answer will be, it will impact not the total assets or liabilities, but only the items of liability, not the asset. That will be the correct answer. Now, second question that pertains to repayment of loan results into what? A loan is repaid. This loan was there. Rupees 2 lakhs is paid. When rupees 2 lakhs is paid, the total liabilities come down by rupees 2 lakhs. What happens to the asset side? Your cash is also reduced or bank balance is reduced by rupees 2 lakhs. Assets also come down. So this also comes down by 2 lakhs. This also comes down by 2 lakhs. Both assets and liabilities are reduced by rupees 2 lakhs. That will be the impact of this particular transaction. And that is the correct answer. Third question is, what happens when fixed assets are purchased on credit? You purchase fixed assets of rupees 6 lakhs on credit basis. You have not paid the money. You will be paying it after 2 years or after 3 years. So what happens to that transaction? How it affects your assets and your liabilities? Your fixed assets have gone up by rupees 6 lakhs. What happened to other assets, total assets? Total assets have gone up by rupees 6 lakhs. What happens to the liabilities? Your loan amount has increased by rupees 6 lakhs. So total liabilities also go up by rupees 6 lakhs. So this particular transaction results into increase in total assets and total liabilities. Another example I have taken, another MCQ which I have asked. What happens when you purchase the, when you sell the goods on credit? You have sold certain goods, inventory. Stock was there. You sold rupees 1 lakh worth of stock. 1 lakh worth of stock was sold to somebody. You did not receive any cash for that. So what happens to total assets or total liabilities? How this transaction affects? It reduces your stock by rupees 1 lakh. And what does it increase? It increases your receivables. You have to receive money from somebody, that is your asset, your receivables are increased by rupees 1 lakh. So total assets remain the same, total liabilities remain the same, whereas we have changed, interchange is there. One particular asset has come down, one particular asset has gone up. Your stocks have come down, whereas your receivables have gone up.